greater trochanteric fractures. The femur is the longest and strongest tubular bone in the human body and one of the principal load-bearing bones in the lower extremity. The thigh bone has two bony processes on the upper part, the greater and lesser trochanters. The greater trochanter is a bony prominence on the lateral aspect of the proximal femur. It serves as the site for multiple muscle insertions including the hip abductors, gluteus medius and minimus, and external rotators, piriformis, obturators, gemelli. Isolated fractures of the greater trochanters are uncommon, particularly in young patients. They are typically avulsion fractures caused by a forceful contraction of the hip abductors. They can also occur from direct trauma such as a fall onto the lateral hip. In older individuals, in the absence of trauma, therefore, it is prudent to evaluate for metastasis or bone lesion. Symptoms and diagnosis. Greater trochanteric fractures cause pain on lateral side of hip that increases with abduction. Difficulty in weight-bearing and occasionally limp present. Tenderness over the greater trochanter. With ecchymosis. When an isolated greater trochanteric fracture occurs, pain is usually local, involving only the hip, and mild. If the pain is more severe, especially if the pain increases during internal rotation, the presence of an occult intertrochanteric fracture should be suspected. Fractured parts of the bone can be seen by conventional X-ray, anteroposterior and lateral views, and CT scans. These imaging techniques often miss portions of the fracture which can give rise to displacement that may necessitate a secondary operation or other complications. Greater trochanter fracture is likely to prompt occult intertrochanteric fractures that can't be seen on plain radiography or CT scan. And thus magnetic resonance imaging, MRI, remains the primary method for further determining the fracture type. Treatment. Most trochanteric fractures heal well with non-operative management, unless significant displacement, greater than 1 cm, is present. We recommend that patients bed rest for 1 month, followed by active exercises and crutch ambulation beginning with partial weight-bearing on affected limb then progress to full weight-bearing, with gradual return to full activity as soon as 2 to 3 months following the injury. Avulsion of the greater trochanter that disrupts the abductor mechanism and displaced fractures more than 1 cm should be referred for surgery. Greater trochanter fracture can be repaired by open reduction and internal fixation with screws, plate, or tension band, depending on the size of the avulsed fragment. Surgical treatment with dynamic hip screw, DHS, is applied to all patients with intertrochanteric extension after magnetic resonance examination. Post-surgical recovery. Range of movement exercises should start in the immediate postoperative period to prevent stiffness. Abductor strengthening exercises can be started after 6 to 8 weeks if there are clinical and radiological signs of healing. For union assessment, X-rays are generally taken immediately after the surgery and at 6 and 12 weeks. Crutch walking with toe-touch weight-bearing should therefore be advised for 3 to 4 weeks. Patient should be fully weight-bearing without aids at 3 months. Contact sports should be avoided for at least 6 months.